August 2nd, 1994. Yeah, isn't it just all about money? Huh? Selling stuff over and over again. You know, since capitalism won, I'm feeling even more anxious that all the free land where little rabbits and bunnies and trees try to grow are developed into large condos for people that want to escape onto another planet. Except we can't get to another planet because there's people walking on the moon up there. You know why people walked on the moon? I don't know why they walked on the moon, but one thing they realized. This is the best gold darn planet to live on. Hey, welcome to Stoney Speaks TV tonight. Got a great show unplanned for you, and why not? Aren't there any spontaneous moments left on the planet? Or is everything all frozen into, you know, obsidian so you can look at it in the life? You know, take a little bit of Woodstock and put it into a little obsidian thing where you can look at it. The saddest news I heard was that the second, or should I say, the only legitimate concert at Bethel was canceled because of lack of tickets, while the people that bought the logo of Woodstock are now, what, $135, only four of you can go at a time? Remember that beautiful anti-commercial moment back in Woodstock in 1969, where people looked at the cyclone fence that was keeping them from their culture and took down the fence and sat down and had what? 10 days? 2 days? 3 days? 5 weeks? Whatever. A whole generation of fun, and why not? Without paying a dime. And you know what? All these people that played that concert, they're doing okay today. But what the heck? Call in here. You can call in here, 769-7422. We're going to be looking at the phone lines here, and there's a lot of things to talk about, right? Huh? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Nobody wants to mention that there are terrorists running out there, shooting abortion doctors, burning up clinics, and what? They're going to post a few marshals around here and there? Oh, you know, it's strange how, quote-unquote, the other side, the right wing, can get away with terrorist groups like... For 150 years? And we blow off an M80 in a toilet in high school? And you get in detention? I don't know. It's a crazy thing, but you know, here we are talking about invading Haiti. And at the same time, we're trying to help people in Rwanda. Can't we, like, call off the invasion and help people in Rwanda and come to back to that? I don't know, but you know what? Gotta always look for the CIA. You know, lift up the welcome mat. In America, see the little bugs that scurry about dealing coke and crack and making the drug flow from Haiti to my... Oh, yeah. And you know they know all about it right now. They set up those cops. The same ones that drove Aristide away. The same ones the U.S. put there. Now the U.S. wants to come back and knock them out. And I'm mixed up. But here we are. Summer. Yeah. Okay. Well, oh, we got a call here, and thankfully, before we got to the long list of what to talk about. Hello, caller, how are you tonight?
I'm all right. This is Big 80, and I don't need some blunt, son.
What's that up?
Blunt.
Okay, well, call again when you feel like it, but what the heck? You know, I mean, we're talking here about money. The whole, you know... It gets me sometimes how people... You call me. Tell me about money. Can we ever get rid of money? Is it possible that we can just, like, take all the money in the world, pile it into a big vat, melt it down, and then make clothes out of it, and we can, like, walk into a store and they'll say, "Hey, buddy, you're dressed like $1 million. Eat up! And why not?" Oh, boy. But here we are taking your call, 769-7422. If you just turned in to this station, I have married Lisa Marie Presley and Michael Jackson. We are now a threesome. Because our privacy must not be invaded, nor our empires commingled in the giant corporate mega music megapolis, which turns all music into like an oatmeal, roughed off at the edges by CD notes that never quite hit the, you know, the music from Woodstock.